The Finance Minister, Matia Kasaija, has supported government's move to borrow from the National Social Security Fund.
Why should I go and borrow from abroad when there is money here? Two, investigations. For sure, everybody must be checked. If we see something that is not which we suspect that it may not be right, I think the government has got all the obligations to investigate. Investigation does not mean that we are criminalizing. We come to check. If you are free, we say we are free, we give you a certificate of cleanliness. If you are not, if there's something wrong, then we tell you to correct it. If you have stolen money, then you know what to do. We go to the law.
This is after members of the National Organization of Trade Unions were disgruntled on this agreement, saying workers saving with the fund might lose money in the process. Minister Kasaija and Betty Yamongi, together with the Deputy Managing Director NSSF Patrick Ayota, say there is no law that stops the Finance Ministry from lending government money from NSSF, especially if there is need.
The mental thing at the fund, any Ugandan can write a letter requesting for money. I get requests from the Catholic Church, I get requests from the Rotary Union, I get requests from the Union. It does not matter because you wrote, we give you the money. Your question should be, do you give out your money? And the answer is, unless it fits certain criteria.
In ministry, I have over 250,000 Ugandans working in the Middle East, majority of whom are sending their money in an ad hoc way to save. And they have expressed willingness to save with NSSF. I have tasked the board to work with the Minister of Foreign Affairs and my ministry to see how the Ugandans in the diaspora will be able to benefit from this new law.
The National Social Security Fund Amendment Act 2022 seeks to expand social security coverage, enhance the spectrum of benefits available to savers, and improve governance of the fund. The Act provides for mandatory contributions by all employers, regardless of the size of the enterprise or number of employees, voluntary contributions to the fund, and top-ups by all members and mid-term access to members' contributions by qualifying members. Report compiled by Yismael Subuga for the news.